Hey guys, Vlad from New England Comic Con Reviews. I'm here with Steve Bloom, the one and only Steve Bloom, the voice of Wolverine, among so many others. How are you today?
I'm really good, man, and you're the best there is at what you do, bub.
That just made my whole weekend. I'm done. Goodbye.
I'm the same way when I hear guys I've been following, man. It's we're all like that. It's all good.
I lost all my train of thought.
Fantastic.
Yeah,
that's what it's
awesome.
All about, right?
So geek moment right there, geeking out, fanboy, fangirl moment, whatever you guys want to say. And the guy behind the camera you met earlier, Cody, he's a huge fan of you as well with the Cowboy Bebop and all that. How is it getting into all the different voices? How difficult is it, or is it come natural to you?
Well, first of all, I appreciate you, Cody. Thank you. It's pretty natural for me. I mean, Spike is really my normal speaking voice. The hard part was the acting, and at first I didn't know what I was doing at all, so I had to be gently guided through that process by my director, who coincidentally is now my girlfriend, who played Julia in the show, Mary Elizabeth McGlynn.
Wow.
So Cowboy Bebop was the show that kept on giving and continues to. But going from voice to voice, it really depends on what I'm looking at. I'm more of a visual and organic actor than anything else. I don't have classic training, so I don't have to rely on rules that might encumber me otherwise. So I'll just dive in. You know, if a character looks like he might have an Australian accent, I'll go right in. You know, so it's not a big deal. Or if I see a character that has more than two arms, I sense some sort of creature thing in there, and I'll put some sort of affectation into it. Or, you know, some kind of growl or slobber. But it's such a natural thing for me. I've been doing it since I was a little kid.
That's awesome. Now, when you come to the cons, what's your favorite part of the cons? The cosplayer, the people, the meeting the fans, how excited they are, like I just did.
All of it, man. It's funny, because when I first started doing this, I was really intimidated by coming to the cons. And I was doing it back in the old days when it was the subbers versus the dubbers, and I was only doing anime. And I would literally get my life threatened. So I was afraid of it for a while. I didn't go for about 10 years after my first experience. And then my friends started talking about how awesome the fans were and the costumes were. And I started going to the cons and hearing the stories from the fans and how the shows that we've been doing in rubber rooms in Los Angeles have been affecting people's lives all over the world in a meaningful way. And when I hear stories about autistic children speaking for the first time because they're connecting with one of my cartoon characters, or guys in the military who are soothing themselves after a horrible day of battle by playing Call of Duty with their buddies, or somebody getting through cancer by connecting with a show that I've worked on, it gives me purpose as a human being, and you know, to continue being creative in the industry.
That's
so
awesome.
So coming to these cons, it fills me up as a human being and just makes me feel like I'm doing something of value.
That's awesome. Now, out of all your voices, and you have hundreds of voices,
mm-hmm.
which one's your favorite, or which one's the one that you relate to more?
Oh, dude, how do you choose? They're like children to me, and each one of them probably represents a different part of my psyche. So from day to day, it would be a different answer. And my stupid joke answer is whatever I'm working on Monday, because it means I'm still employed.
Yeah.
But probably the one that has affected my life more than any of the other ones would be Cowboy Bebop, just because it led to so many other things. It led to Toonami, it led to Megas XLR, and even Legend of Korra. The guys were fans of Cowboy Bebop, and they hired me because of that. And
which I love, by the way.
Yeah, me too.
Started rewatching it yesterday.
Yes, and you've been purified. So. The revolution has officially begun right here.
Again, there goes my thought. Yay! That's awesome.
Yay! We don't need thoughts for this business.
No, we
it's
don't.
Good.
Not at all. It's great. It's so much fun talking to you. It's a great. What's your next project coming up?
Well, I can't tell you, or I'd have to kill you. I'm working on probably a dozen things right now that I can't talk about. It breaks my heart not to share it with you, but I'm not allowed to.
We can expect a lot more.
There's a lot more games, a lot more shows. Working on two new series now that I can't talk about. But Star Wars Rebels is the big thing that's continuing. We just completed season 2 on the air. Season 3 is coming up in the fall. And the show is just going to get bigger and better. And it's more connective tissue for the canon. Amazing. We're putting a lot of heart and soul and love into that. And I'm still doing Toonami every week. I'm recording from home and up every Saturday night at 11:30. And then some more regular show coming. And like I said, lots more games and stuff too.
Where can people follow you? If they want to follow social media, Facebook, Twitter, any of that?
Yeah, I'm on Twitter at BloomSpew. It's BloomSpew, like spewing. And then Facebook, just under my name, I have a fan page there. And my website is stevebloomvoices.com.
All right. Steve, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure. I'm going to talk with him a little bit more off camera because it's great hearing the voices. Vlad from New England Comic Con Reviews with Steve Bloom at MassiveCon, guys. If you weren't here, too bad. Awesome show.
You missed it, people. Next year, be here or I'll come find you. I'm a bounty hunter. Bang.